Welcome back to the final segment of the show. You're here with Ray, Sandra, and Danielle. And we're here with Regal Arce, who is the owner of Regal Pest Prevention, a local company here in Tucson. And before we talk a little bit about bugs, I want to talk about the half triathlon.
Yes, we did it.
Okay, let's talk a little bit about it. Come on, man. Let's go.
Well, yeah, I trained all summer for it. But yeah, Tempe held the 70.3 half Ironman. And it's a full Ironman sponsored event. Top athletes in this field were there. Top 40 would make it to the finals in New Zealand in 2024.
Right.
I got to tell you, I was so impressed. Not only the way they ran the venue, but it was 1,200 souls just banging into each other in the water, on the street, on the bike, you know, running. The temperatures couldn't be any hotter. It was brutal. I got to tell you, if you finished that event on Sunday, you were proud.
Yeah.
You know, no matter your time. I set a pretty lofty goal. And I actually had one gal tell me, a real estate agent of mine, she said, I think you're a little overzealous on that. I said, oh, thanks. But no, it was great. I met a lot of folks. I learned a ton. I'm super proud of myself. It was a great experience. And yeah, I've got the bug. I'm already looking at Chattanooga in May next year. In the Chattanooga River or something like that. It looked really cool.
Wow.
There's one in Idaho that looks really, really sweet. I'd like to get in on that one.
That's going to be cold.
Right? Yeah, cold water. Thank God for wetsuits. You know, so
really?
I'll tell you, what a great experience. But, you know, there were people there, you know, easily in their 70s, even early 80s, I think. It, just unbelievable.
Wow.
I mean, you want to talk about inspired. And so if you were feeling bad for yourself at any time, you just looked at one of them and thought, look at, you know, and of course they ran by you, you know, and you just thought, wow, I want to be like him or her, you know, and it was great. It was great. A real community. Everybody had the, you know, the same passion, the same goal, you know, finish. So it was great. Made me feel alive, you know, and like I said, I'm super proud of myself and I'm looking forward to the next one.
Did you get any secret training advice and stuff like that on what to do next?
No, but I'm going to solicit it. I actually, seriously, I've actually got offered a couple of coaching offers. You know, not offers, but you know, people help, and I'm actually going to take them up on it. I think that there's a lot to learn and apply, and especially if you're taking it seriously and you want to aim for some lofty goals, and so I'm going to look into that. I really am. Yeah.
What month is the Chattanooga one?
That one's in May.
Okay, so it's not like next 6 weeks you're going to be going to do something.
No, taking a break. In fact, that day and a few days after, I ate a lot of pizza and had a lot of, and had a lot of beer. In fact, I'll say it again, a lot of beer.
Oh, well, you look extremely fit.
Well, yes.
And, I you should be so proud.
It was great. It was a great experience.
There's silence on the radio. This is that moment we all fear.
I'm all good about it. I just want to make sure I don't take over the whole show.
So I'm looking at all your handsome faces. It doesn't bother me the least.
We were talking about a little bit we haven't brought up again, the commercial service that you do for the community.
Right. Yeah, we're starting to really expand in that arena now. The big thing is I mentioned availability earlier.
Uh-huh.
With commercial service, you have to be available. Commercial consumer calls, you've got to be ready.
Right.
That's their business. There's all hours of operation, and they have patrons that they need to keep happy and keep coming in to purchase their products. And so a pest control company has to be what I always call in my years of experience, a silent partner.
Right.
The consumer should never know that there's a pest control company involved. The patrons are there to enjoy the service or the product. And so my client is trusting that we're going to keep them bug free and we're going to do it professionally and discreetly, which is critical, you know. Mm-hmm. So, we're the size now that I've got enough staff to do this. And so we are venturing out and marketing such that we provide commercial service.
Good.
Yeah. And so it's exciting. I love being behind the scenes in commercial operations. In fact, I just put together work for a really cool coffee shop, a local coffee shop. And they have a great bean, by the way. They roast their own, you know, their own product there right on site.
You can throw their name out.
Black Crown Coffee. Come on, give it up for Black
All
Crown
right.
Coffee
right.
on Speedway. Yeah. It is a great bean, by the way. And, you know, in the end, we become partners. And what we do is we keep them safe.
Uh-huh.
so that they can deliver their good service and product, and it makes a partnership. And I got to tell you, I love that.
What I was thinking about, is their preventive maintenance service the same as a residential service, like once a year?
It's actually amped up. It's prevention and observation and communication on steroids.
So you're there more than you...
You're there potentially more. So instead of quarterly, it's monthly.
Wow.
Right,
okay.
So you're there more. But the communication is off the charts. There is sanitation recommendations, sealing up openings to keep things from getting in, best practices as it relates to storing dry goods and boxes and supplies. There are a lot of factors that a commercial facility should employ to keep it as pest-free, or as I like to say, inhospitable, mm-hmm. right, to mm-hmm. bugs. Bugs love mess. They love just, the worse the conditions, the better.
Mm-hmm.
We want to encourage our clients to make it pristine so it's not attractive to insects.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And you've talked before about how in these places, especially if they serve food, that you have to be very careful and there are very strict guidelines on what you're doing to help them treat it and how important that prevention is, especially with people that have maybe sensitivities to some of the products that are out there and different things. Can you share just a little bit more about kind of how that works in the commercial space?
Absolutely. Certain pesticides can't be used in a commercial kitchen. So you have to make your choices very carefully. There's selective products that are employed.
Mm-hmm.
Time of day, whether the facility is occupied or not occupied, that's a very, very big factor. And just the products in themselves, in what we call a formulation. Some products can get airborne, and so you have to be super careful, where they're applied. There's a lot of machinery that has fans and motors, and they blow. So you have to really be sharp in mm-hmm. a commercial establishment. So you're making very careful strategic applications. And there are a lot of sensitivities, especially when you're dealing with the medical field,
right,
or daycare or childcare. There are some real restrictions. The big thing with pest control, besides prevention and sanitation and sealing things up, is a very big phrase in our industry called monitoring. Just putting out little sticky trap, glue traps, right? What we call them insect monitors, to sound technical, but just installing a series of those in strategic places is wonderful pest control. No pesticides, nothing airborne, but yet they capture rogue insects and tell us a story.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And so monitoring is a big, big factor in effective pest control in these sensitive areas that Danielle mentioned.
Mm-hmm.
You know, one of the things I want to talk about too is you've talked a little bit about the quality of service, but the system that you guys have in place, because we use your company for both pest control and then also weed control. And I will get a phone call from a tech to set the appointment. I'll get text messages. I mean, you guys just have that down pat.
Well, thank you. I'm glad to hear that. We're always looking to be better, and sometimes it does, break down. But yeah, communication, I don't ever want to lose the communication with my customers. Pest control, I always felt, was very intimate, to use that word, if I may.
In people's homes.
It's personal.
Part of it.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's very personal. And I don't want my company to become this corporate sort of robotic systems generated, we're going to be here between 8 and 12 and whether you like it or not, blah, blah, blah. I want to communicate with my customer. I want to make sure that they're happy, that it works for them. We do want to provide the service, but we don't want to force it down their throat either.
Mm-hmm.
And so communication is extremely important. And we want to be fair, we want to be thorough, we want to be safe, and we want to be friendly. And I think if we do all that, we've got a very long-term relationship.
I want to throw out real quick, jumping back to those sticky traps.
Yeah.
I am a big fan of those sticky traps.
Tell me about it.
How many times have you ever caught a snake inside someone's house in a sticky trap?
Multiple times. And here's the good news, if anybody hears that and thinks, oh boy, they can actually be released. The counteractant to a glue board, right? That's what they are, glue boards or sticky traps. Is vegetable oil. Little vegetable oil that lizard, mm-hmm. snake, even non-threatening snake slithers right off, but yes, They capture things, for sure. Even things you don't want it to capture, like you know, a cat or a toddler. But my Australian Shepherd, to name something. The vegetable oil is a counteractant, you know. But they're non-toxic, and they just really are a nice peace of mind, a tool that works 24 hours a day behind the scenes.
I did not know that you could release them.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
That's great.
Yep.
I'm not a fan.
Outside. Not outside. In the house. Outside.
Outside.
Yeah, that snake doesn't
you
need to come
back
in.
You can't be everywhere, Rico. And the thing that I'm noticing about your technique and your applications and things you talk about is what all your agents know. So when they come out there, they're very well trained and very well skilled.
Yeah.
I mean, they carry you right onto their job. So you do a great job doing the training for your
very
guys.
Flattering. When an agent represents you and starts articulating your verbiage, that's a humbling, flattering sort of thing, you know. But I've been saying these things for a long time in front of you. So I quiz you every now and then. But no, that's the best. You know, that's such a compliment, and I always appreciate that. But again, that just comes back to being educators. And so we have our office meeting coming up, and if you guys attended it, you'd see me up front and center sharing all this with my team over and over and over and over. Yep.
We want to thank you for being here, but tell our listeners how they can get a hold of you.
Yeah, so the local number, 520-744-6177. That's the main office. And then you can look us up, rigopest.com. That's RIGOPEST.com. And if you're talking to Danielle, you can look us up on our Facebook page. Danielle has got me in a headlock right now, wanting me to amp that up a little more. But that's how you can reach us.
Awesome. Hey, we want to thank all of our sponsors: Pioneer Title Agency, Indy Realty, Inspired Life Mortgage, Rigo Pest Prevention, and Power Solar. If you use them, please let them know you heard about them on the I Am Real Estate Show.
Thanks, Rigo.
Yeah.